A great way to summarize data. So let's take a look at some of the features of charts. To begin with, we're going to select some data. Let's start with age range. And we want to take a look at a revenue breakdown per age range. So we select revenue. Now, to select the chart type that I want, I can choose from various items on the left here. So I can create a column chart, a line chart, an area chart, a bar chart, and lastly a pie chart. So once I select the type of chart that I think is most appropriate, I can simply click on the Advanced Configurations. What's important to note is that I can add more data. So over here, if I want to add another field, I can simply go and add that, and I can just as easily remove that field. Once I've selected the basic data I want to work with, I can come to the Advanced Configurations and then add some additional formatting. And on the right, I can add some settings for the look and feel as well as the filter settings. So now let's break this up with another variable. In this case, we can choose gender. And now I can get a breakdown based on gender. There are various options available for the design. So the first thing I can change is the type of chart, the subtype. I can create a stack chart or a stacked 100. I can show a legend and decide where I want to position it. I can add value labels, so I can now see the label and position where I think it's most appropriate. Choose to show and hide the grid lines in the chart, as well as the specific axes. Lastly, when a widget contains more data than can be comfortably displayed in one view, this option displays a zoom bar, and I can zoom into the particular sections of the view as needed. And of course, we can add filters to restrict the view of data. In addition, it's easy to change the different chart. So for instance, I can move to a line chart, and it will represent the same data. On the right side, I get slightly different menu items, depending on the type of chart. So for a line chart, I can choose a smooth or straight line, I can increase the width, and I can add markers and set how the markers should be represented. This chart is an area chart. Again, I have several subtypes from which I can select. So I can select stacked or stacked 100. The bar chart also has similar features to the column chart. Again, I can choose the subchart that I'm interested in and set the legends and value labels. And the last chart that I want to talk about is the pie chart. So the first thing you'll notice if we go back to the pie chart setting is that I have two variables that I can supply, the categorical variable as well as the actual calculation that I want to perform. So this is a breakdown of revenue based on gender. Also, I have an option to choose a donut or a ring chart. So once these settings are in place, I can click on Apply and add the new chart to the dashboard. I can also add a title by clicking over here and typing the title, and I can add additional descriptive information by adding a description as well. So once it's done, I can click Apply and the chart is added to my dashboard. For more information about charts, see our online documentation.